Hello everybody, good morning. Today I'm going to talk about Ashok Leyland, which came with a good set of numbers about a week back. And if you say, on a quarterly basis, QOQ basis, the numbers were disappointing, and that was quite expected in line because, we know that the COVID pandemic was quite strong in Q1 FY22, which was not that strong in Q4 FY21, and that's why the numbers were sharply below on a quarterly basis, that is QOQ basis. But if you see going forward, we believe that the MHCV drivers such as construction activities, infrastructure projects, monsoon, mining activities, all are quite in place. So we believe that this Q1 was just an aberration, and MHCV growth will come back on its track from Q2 onwards, provided wave 3 of the pandemic doesn't arise at all or it's quite small. Secondly, on LCV business, I would say that the company is doing very well over there because of the demand for last mile transportation, like e-commerce, FMCG products, pharma products, etc., is going quite well despite the pandemic. Even during the COVID pandemic wave 1, wave 2, this LCV business has been going out with a very impressive performance. Thirdly, we believe that exports are also coming back slowly on track, with Africa, Southeast Asia, Latin America, also performing well and coming back on track. So overall, on the margins front also, we believe that the company's modular program and other cost cutting programs, as well as price hikes that the company is taking, that will be helping them to gain the lost margins which we have seen in Q1 of FY22. So overall, I think with a slim capex guidance going forward, and a strong balance sheet, margins improvement, volume improvement, etc., we believe that Ashok Leyland will be back on track with a bang in Q2, and also in the remaining part of FY22 as well as in FY23. So we are quite positive on the stock, with a target at about 150 rupees. So that is one stock which an investor can be into because of its number two position in the MHCV industry, as well as its strength, overall core strength in its numbers, like margins, balance sheet, etc. Even its return ratios are quite strong. So I would recommend this particular stock on 1 year term horizon. Thank you.